The killing of George Floyd changed the world. I mean, there is no question about that. We can't even begin to measure how much it's changed. What it did, I think, for a lot of white people was make them sort of see that police brutality is very real and that what it looks like is very, very ugly.
When Kamala Harris says that America's not racist, but black people put you in office, but you have not put any policies in effect for us, we beg to differ. And I don't think that Kamala Harris doesn't want to. I just think because of racism, people feel like they have to approach, I have to take care of white people's issues first instead of dealing with what's the most important issues at the time.
I'm Michelle Gross, and I'm the president of Communities United Against Police Brutality. Minnesota has this long reputation of being a very liberal state, very kind of friendly state and that sort of stuff. But that's kind of the veneer. And underneath, there's a very different story. Black drivers in Minneapolis are 29 times more likely than white drivers to be pulled over by cops. And this is in a very white state. Blacks make up about 19% of Minneapolis proper, about 12% of the whole state. There is a thing where somebody gets shot, and typically you don't see that video and you hear about it and you go, gosh, isn't that terrible? I mean, I have bigger reactions than that, but I think a lot of average white folk are like, that's terrible, but what did they do, you know? This was so clear that this man had done nothing to cause this. It was agonizing to watch this man die over 9.5 minutes. People got to see the long, slow trajectory of a man dying, begging and pleading for his life and calling for his mother.
I'm Traren Cruz. I'm the lead organizer with BLM Minnesota, and I live here in St. Paul, Minnesota. St. Paul, just statistically, this is like one of the best places to live if you're white, but the worst place to live if you're black. Everyday life is just the police pulling people over, not being able to get along, how you're being called the N-word in school, or teachers calling your daughter the N-word and things like that. So those are some of the issues that people face on a day-to-day basis. We got housing disparities, we have employment disparities, we have a wealth gap that is very substantial. And according to Demos, this is driven by public policy decisions that are made by some of the lawmakers here.
I've lived in the Twin Cities my whole life. These are not just names. These are actual living beings whose life was cut short unjustly, and there are people still grieving. And it's like, it's time for that grieving, that type of grieving to not happen anymore. I see black men walk by sometimes and I just look at them and I go, what is it like to live with that fear?
This is for George, who cannot experience this freedom. This is for all the people that decided not to come, who they cannot feel this freedom. That's why we're here. That's why you're here in the gap to bring it, you know, so that people that are unable to get here can know the truth. That, you know what? Yes, surely an atrocity happened, but this is what we're doing. We have ashes for the beauty for these ashes. These ashes were turning into beauty. That's it. 1 year later, it means that there's oil in the lamp and it's flickering. And every time everyone comes back and comes, they're bringing oil and the flame is getting larger and brighter. That's what it means to me. This is me standing in the gap for everyone that has ever fallen, ever in humanity. That's why I'm here. This is for everyone who has ever fallen in humanity in all of time.